Hey guys, I'm back, and this time I'm back with this cut crease. I know it's been a while since I've filmed. I have been neglecting YouTube, but I'm back. I am back, and I have this cut crease for you. I hope you guys like it. I know it can be intimidating when creating a cut crease, but it really, really, it truly is not as hard as it looks. If you guys want to see how I created this look, then please keep watching. So I already did my brows off camera, and I concealed and set my eyelids. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started with this tutorial. I have not been on here for a while. I am back on it. For today, I'm going to be using the Just Peachy Mattes palette for my transition color. By the way, this palette is everything. This palette is awesome. Awesome. I'm going to go ahead and start with my transition color. I'm going to use Peaches and Cream, this shade down here. I'm going to bring it all the way out. This tutorial is for Veronica. She really, really wants to learn how to do a cut crease, so this is for you. I go in with a very light transition shade because I like to bring it up pretty high. I'm coming all the way into my inner corner. And that's why I use a very, very light transition shade, because I can come all the way in, I can go all the way up. Notice at the end, I am flicking up. I'm creating like a wing at the very end up here. Right there, and then just blend up. Now, every shade you use, make sure you bring out into that wing. The technique is, I would say, don't come too far down into lid, just because when you start looking for your crease, it can make it a little difficult if the crease color comes down too far into your lid. So try to stay into that crease. Notice when I flick out the brush down here, notice I blend right here as well. So I flick out, but then I come up with it. I'm going to go up a shade, and I'm gonna use Fresh Picked, and it's this shade down here. And I'm gonna do the same exact thing with that shade. Remember to kind of stay focused in that crease. And the same with this shade. Flick it out. Notice I'm staying in that crease. Notice I'm not going wild with it yet. I'm just trying to concentrate it in that crease. Then I blend out. And I'm starting to see that wing right there. I'm gonna do the same with the other eye. Quick tip for these fluffy brushes when you're doing this, grab it, don't dip your brush in like this, dip it in at an angle. So like to where it does, you have it on this side, not on this side, just on that side. And then that'll make it easier to concentrate it in that crease. Blending. I'm gonna go up to Peach Cobbler, which is that shade right there. And the same thing, grab it on the side of that fluffy brush, put in the crease, and flick it out. Once we get into the darker colors, I'm gonna do some cranberry colors, and once we get into those colors, we're gonna switch the brush. And I will show you what brush I'm gonna use. You need this brush in your life. It is very, very easy to do a cut crease with this brush. And I will show you which one it is here in just a second. Now, for the darker colors, I'm going to use this brush. I got this brush at Walgreens. Yes, at Walgreens. And I love it for my cut creases. I am going to use this small. It's really, really small. And it kind of has a point to it. So it makes it very easy to get in that crease and draw the line. So I'm gonna go in with Peach Punch. And I have not used to that shade yet. I really don't tap off the excess too much just because I need a concentrated amount for the line. With this, I'm being way more precise. If you could see, I'm coming all the way into my inner corner. And I'm literally drawing a line, which I'm going to blend here in a minute. There's an e.l.f. brush I've been using for my cut creases. It makes it a lot easier to blend this line, and I'll show you in just a minute which brush I'm talking about. It doesn't have a name, but it's kind of flat, kind of fluffy at the very, very top. And I'm gonna go in with same shade Peach Punch, tap off the excess on this one because this is what I'm gonna use to blend that line. Notice I'm not going too crazy with it. I'm literally just erasing that harsh line that we left. Blending out. Don't forget to blend out the wing you created. Once I've erased that harsh line that I created with Peach Punch, I'm gonna go in with my fluffy brush again, and I'm gonna take some of that transition shade I used. Although it is a cut crease, we don't want the top to look harsh. We don't want any harsh lines on the top. We want the top to be very well blended. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with a bit darker shade. I'm not gonna go too dark. I'm gonna go in, it's pretty dark, with Peach Sangria, which is this dark cranberry shade down here. And the same thing, I'm gonna draw a line. And I am tapping off the excess because I don't want a crazy grid. I'm gonna go in with this crease blending brush, and I'm gonna blend that red out. And my fluffy brush again, and I'm just going to blend. So we have that finished. Looks funky. It does. I know it, and it's supposed to look this way. Now comes the fun part. We're going to carve out our crease. For this, I'm gonna be using this small concealer brush. It's very small. It's flat. I'm gonna be using it to carve out my lid. I open my eye and I find my crease, of course, first. And I put a dot where my crease begins. I do tug on my eye a little. So remember, it's way easier if you start with a dot and then just work your way from there. And then right here on this outside part, on the wing part, I'm And then I fill that in with concealer. I take my finger and I blend the concealer out. I wipe off my brush that I used and I just drag that line down. Always blend with your finger. So I'm gonna start applying my shadow to my lid because I don't want it to crease. And for that, I'm gonna use this flap Wet n Wild brush. And I'm gonna use peach butter for my lid. It's such a good shade for a matte cut crease.
Excuse the noise in the background. My husband was watching the football game. In case you were wondering, we are Cowboys fans. Hate it or love it.
So you could leave it like this. Add a wing liner. Pop some lashes on. But I'm gonna be a bit extra. I'm gonna draw a glitter line where I cut the crease. Because I'm extra. I get my ring finger and I grab some of that shade and I go back in just to make sure I got all my lid. And it should look like this. Then I'm gonna go in to the other eye and I'm gonna do the same exact thing. Now I am going to curl my eyelashes. I'm gonna curl my eyelashes before I add my glitter line because I don't wanna ruin the glitter once it's on there. Always, always curl your eyelashes if you're gonna wear falsies. The eyelashes I'm gonna be using today are from Eylure in the style Gilded. They're beautiful, they're gorgeous. They're brand new, I'm about to try them on, cut, and all that good stuff. Remember to let the lash glue sit on the tip for a minute before you apply your lashes so it gets tacky on the tip and it's ready to go once you apply it to the lashes. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and do my glitter. This is the fun part. So the glitter is, I think, the easiest part because you're literally just following that line you created, you carved out with the concealer. You're literally following that line. You're going right on top of that line. So I really, really hope you can see me. The glitter I'm using is from, it's called Heavy Metal, and it is from, it's in the shade Midnight Cowboy, and I cannot, it's from Urban Decay, I thought it was from Too Faced, from Urban Decay. It was like $20, but totally, totally worth it. I bring that glitter way out here. There's your glitter line. Nothing to it. Literally, I'm following that line. That's literally all I'm doing. So I'm gonna do my other eye. you come too far down into the lid, just get that flat brush you used for your lid color and take off the glitter. Now, try not to open your eye because it will transfer to your crease. So try to keep your eye closed for a little, your eyes closed for a little bit until it dries. Now I'm going to cut my lashes. Always try on your lashes before you put them on, because if they're too long, they're gonna poke you either in your inner corner or your outer corner. And it's really uncomfortable and it makes your eye water. And then it'll ruin your eyelashes. So my glue should already start looking tacky. Doesn't that look amazing? Awesome. Once you have your lashes on, the inner corner highlight, the brow bone highlight, foundation on, oh, it looks so gorgeous. I got so many compliments on this. I went to the fair and we went out for dinner, and I got so many compliments on my makeup. And I got a few girls asking me to film a tutorial for this. And I've been neglecting YouTube, so I was like, why not? Why not? Is it only me? Like, when you get hairs down your back, like in between your shirt and your back, it bugs me. Like, it bothers me. Like, it bothers me really bad. Is it only me? I think we're ready to place this bad boy. No! Cut to my eyelid. Look at the difference the eyelash makes. Just the eyelash. Isn't that crazy? Look gorgeous. Okay, now moving on to the face. I think we'll move on to the face now. I'm going to grab my Wachs Up highlighter. I'm gonna grab that on my finger. I'm gonna place it on my cheekbone. And then I grab some on the back of my Beauty Blender. And I just grab a brush. I'm just gonna set the rest of my face. While I'm baking, I'm going to warm up and contour my face. I'm gonna be using the butter bronzer from Physicians Formula. I use this quite often. For my contour, I'm going to use my Hoola bronzer. Again, I've been bringing that contour all the way down to my mouth. Grab an angled brush and I'm going to set my nose contour. My lip to make it look poutier. I'm going to clean up my contour. We can now clean up the forehead. I'm going to highlight my brow bone, my temples. For my brow bone, I'm going to use that same flat brush I used for my lid color. Look at that. You guys see that? And then I'm gonna grab that fluffy blending brush. I'm gonna go into my transition shade, the peaches and cream. And I'm gonna merge my transition shade and my height. Now for my bottom lash line, I'm not gonna go too crazy. I'm just going to get my crease blending brush. I'm gonna grab peach cobbler. This one. I'm gonna grab some of that. I'm just gonna put some on my bottom lash line. I'm gonna grab some peach punch, the shade I used for my crease. And then I'm gonna grab peach sangria. And make it mainly on the outside. I'm going to waterline my upper lash line using my Holy Grail. It's the NYX Retractable Waterproof Eyeliner. I'm going to put them on my bottom lash line. Not smudging it at all. That already makes a difference. I'm going to dust off the rest of my translucent powder. You can taste it. You could already see the highlight peeking through. I'm gonna highlight again. Go ham and cheese with my highlighter. I'm gonna grab my pinky and I'm gonna pop some of my inner corners. I'm gonna grab flat little brush again. Put my nose. Little exclamation mark. Cupid's bow. For my blush, I'm gonna be using the Tarte blush in the shade Party. It is a beautiful shade. It's like not too pink, not too brown. It's just perfect. I actually got this at Sephora for free for my birthday. And I have not put it down since the day I got it. That's all I've been using. Remember to always do your contour, highlight, and then your blush. So that way you don't have a big old streak of highlighter on your cheeks. Those will kind of merge all three colors together. So that's done. I am going to do my hair off camera and I'll be right back.